That.
Yes, thank you very much, President. I have to say that I am very skeptical on the summit of tomorrow and Friday, as Mr. Draghi is also very skeptical about it. Today in the press, Mr. Draghi is quoted in saying that he fears vague and slow decisions, that he is disappointed by the lack of ambition for the summit. And let's be honest, it's true. Last June, the European Council decided that before the end of the year, and I'm quoting now, we should have a time-bound roadmap for the achievement of a genuine economic and monetary union to bring back confidence in the markets. And we all applauded here in the Parliament. And what draft conclusions we have for the summit of tomorrow? In fact, almost nothing. They are very vague. There is no clear roadmap. There is no real backing of the Van Rompuy paper in the conclusions. There is not even welcoming the blueprint of the Commission. And I see that, President, that the only outcome tomorrow will be that the Council will decide on the single supervisory mechanism. But I thought I have to tell you that we did that already in the past. The Council has decided on this in June. The Council has decided the second time, you remember, Mr. Barroso, that we did it here, this debate with Mr. Van Rompuy, decided on this a second time in October. And now it's the third time that we shall decide on the single supervisory mechanism. It becomes, in fact, ridiculous. Like it is also, in my opinion, ridiculous what I heard from some European leaders, Mr. Hollande, in Oslo, stating that the crisis is over now. What crisis is over? The crisis is not over. Not economically, not socially, certainly, if you see all the damage on the economic field, and not financially. Look, for example, last days the spreads went up again for Spain above 400. Today, yesterday, 3 days ago, for Portugal, went up again. Ireland went up again. Not to talk about Italy, but there are other reasons for, naturally, for that phenomenon. So and my request to the President of the Council is, really, is that the type of conclusions? Maybe you have better no summit tomorrow and after tomorrow than this type of summit, because finally it shall create more problems in the markets than resolve it. Because you're clearly not delivering what you have promised 6 months ago. And my second request is to the Commission, that has done a lot of work in the blueprint, but every time saying, okay, yeah, it's within the treaties, and the treaty doesn't allow this, and the treaty doesn't allow that, and we have to come back after 2014. Maybe it's a good proposal to have fast European elections. Because the real reason why we cannot do a number of things, for example, the redemption fund, for example, a fiscal capacity for the Eurozone, for example, treasury bills. We all know it. It's not a treaty, Mr. Barroso. The real reason is political, because there are elections in Germany, and before September, we cannot decide on all these topics that are so important. That's the real reason. So my proposal is to be very honest on it, And not to say every time, it's not possible for the treaty here, it's not possible for the treaty there. There is now a new decision of the European Court of Justice, the Pringle judgment. Take the Pringle judgment. The Pringle judgment makes it possible, treasury bills. The Pringle judgment makes it possible, the redemption fund. The Pringle judgment makes it possible, a fiscal capacity for the Eurozone. And if you say no, well, look to the Council. In the last trilogue, even the Council Legal Service contradicted you on this issue and said that it is possible under the conditions of the Pringle judgment. Et puis, finalement, Monsieur le Président, ma dernière remarque, c'est sur l'Italie. C'est quand même insensé ce qui se passe pour le problème qu'il y a un homme politique qui dit qu'il va retourner, le gouvernement tombe, et l'Italie est en crise et toute l'eurozone rentre de nouveau en crise. Et je sais bien que Joseph Daul hier a pris ses distances. Je vais simplement lui demander encore une chose supplémentaire. Mets-le dehors du PP et du Parti populaire européen. Que c'est fini cette affaire. Et que l'Italie peut retrouver la stabilité le plus vite possible. Et aussi l'eurozone. Parce que, en fait, Quel jeu on est en train de jouer? Qui sera là demain dans le sommet du PPE? Il sera là? Peut-être vous voulez nous indiquer, à côté de Mme Merkel et à côté des autres. Merci beaucoup pour votre attention.